You can integrate indirect, capital, and non-sponsored project types from the EPM Planning Projects module with Project Management. After both EPM Planning and Project Management are configured for integration, you can implement an integration workflow that involves multiple users. An EPM Project Planner creates projects, plans summary expenses, and approves projects in EPM Planning. They then run integration jobs to push projects and project budgets to Project Management. Once the projects exist in Project Management, an admin-level user assigns a project manager. The project manager then creates a detailed project budget against the strategic budget that came from EPM Planning. Actual data is collected in Project Management as the project proceeds. At regular intervals, the EPM Project Planner or a planning administrator imports project actuals to EPM Planning, where they perform variance analysis between actual and planned data. They can then replan the budget and export updates to Project Management, where the project manager creates a new version of the detailed budget. Let's start by adding an indirect project. In EPM Planning, open the Project Summary page and select the Indirect tab. On the Project Details tab, right-click and select Add Project. Enter a project name, optional description, and a start and end date. Click Next to continue. On the Options page, enter a project number and select a template. Project templates are defined and managed in Project Management and are represented in EPM Planning in Smart Lists. When you integrate the project with Project Management, the template you select here is used for project creation. Click Launch to create the project. The project is added to the Project Details list with a status of New. The integration status is No Integration Status. Next, let's plan for project expenses. On the Direct Input tab, select the project in the POV. I'll enter expenses for labor, material, equipment, and others. Labor, material, and equipment are mapped to the labor, material, and equipment resource classes in Project Management. Other expenses is mapped to the Financial Resources resource class. You can change the default mappings on the Map Members tab in the Integration Job Setup. Save the data. Finally, right-click in the form and run the Calculate Expenses rule. After planning expenses, new projects must be approved in EPM Planning before you integrate them with Project Management. Return to the Project Details page, right-click the project, and select Approve Projects. Verify that the correct project is selected, then launch the approval. The project is now approved, and the integration status is updated to Initial. After creating new projects, the database must be refreshed before running integrations. I've already refreshed the database. Now, let's integrate approved projects and project budgets with Project Management. Under Application, select Data Exchange. Note, EPM Planning includes a set of integration jobs for each calendar defined in Project Management. If you have multiple project calendar types, you'll see a prefix in front of the integration job name to indicate which calendar type it applies to. First, run the Export Projects integration job to create new projects in Project Management. I'll use the beginning balance for the start and end period. I'll keep the other default settings and click Run to start the integration. The integration completed successfully. Click Close to return to the Data Integration page. Next, run the Export Project Budgets integration job to push your project budget from EPM Planning to Project Management. Select the time periods you want to export. On the Filters tab, you can change the defaults to export a different version, scenario, entity, and so on. I'll keep the defaults and run the integration. After the integration completes successfully, close the integration dialog. When you return to the Project Details page, you can verify that the integration status for the project is now integrated. Now let's verify the project was created in Project Management. I'm signed in as an administrator. navigate to Project Financial Management, and search for the new project. The project was created and has a status of active. When you view the project tasks and select Manage Project Budget, you can see that the project budget was also imported from EPM Planning. Next, assign a project manager, a user who enters project budgets and monitors its progress. Right-click in the project row and select Manage Financial Project Settings. On the Parties tab, under Team Members, click Add. I'll add a team member and select the role of Project Manager. I'll specify a start date, but leave the end date open. When you're done, click Save and Close. Let's sign out as the administrator and sign back in as the project manager. Navigate to Project Management. Use the Tasks list to view a list of your projects and search for the project name. In the Project Actions, select Manage Project Budget. You can view the strategic budget from EPM Planning. Notice that all of the line items I entered in EPM Planning were imported. I'll create a detailed budget using the strategic budget from EPM Planning as a reference. I'll enter detail line items for the budget. When you're done, save the budget. If an approval workflow is configured for the budget, you'll have the option to submit it for approval. The system will either auto-reject or auto-approve the budget according to the threshold rules defined in the workflow. As the project is executed over time, actual transactions are collected in project management. Periodically, EPM project planners or a planning administrator can import these actual costs from project management to EPM planning. You can run the integration job on demand or schedule it to run on a regular basis, such as weekly or monthly. Let's run the integration. I'll import the collected actuals. Now let's calculate the project expenses. Under Projects, select Expense. Select Review Project Expense, then select the Project Expense tab. Under Actions, select Business Rules. Then select Calculate Currencies, Total Project Expense. Now that actual data is imported and calculated, you can compare plan and actual data in a variance analysis. Based on your analysis, you can replan the budget and export it to project management as a new version of the strategic budget. Related videos and the Unified Planning, Budgeting, Execution, and Analysis of Projects technical brief are linked in the description. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.